Welcome, it's Kat right here. So today in this video, we are doing for you a comparison of duct tape and for pickleball court striping. My parents have a sports court that they are turning into 3 pickleball courts. We'll show you a little bit of details about that. My dad will be doing most of this video with a comparison, very detailed comparison of all this, and then we can show you which would be the best option, price versus quality.
Good morning. I am Kat Ray's dad. Today we're going to talk about lining a pickleball court with regular old duct tape you find at the hardware store. As you can see, my wife and her friends are playing today. And in 2002, we built our house on 4.5 acres with the idea we'd have some horses. We also put a sports court in the back. We looked into different options and we initially designed the sports court as a hockey rink. Our kids were playing hockey. But we also wanted to put a tennis court in. So we did this. A normal tennis court is 78 by 36, including the doubles court. A normal tennis court pad is about 120 by 60. We wanted to save some money, so we made it 100 by 50. Then we got older and got into pickleball, so we put a pickleball court in the middle of the tennis court. That worked fine, except the sun is coming from the right, which is the east, in the morning when we play. And unfortunately, it blinds everybody in the left or the west court. So we said, now what are we gonna do? Don't forget the tennis court here is 78 by 36. Pickleball court is 44 by 20. And this is what we looked like originally. In a regular tennis court, you can orient them like this and actually put 4 pickleball courts in because it's 60 by 120. Since we are limited, we did this and made 2 sideways end courts against the center court so that the end lines of the center court become portions of the sidelines of the end courts. And the end courts are facing north and south so you don't get blinded in the early morning sun. And this is our final configuration. And hey, while we're doing this, we want to make sure that we like it, so we're going to use tape instead of paint. And we said, why don't we try some different types of tape that you can find around the house? We started off with some tape for $25 a roll. We got off the internet, and it really didn't work very well. It came up. It was some vinyl PVC tape and we didn't like it, so we said let's just go buy some local duct tape in different varieties and see what we can come up with. And then after a month we'll check it and see which ones stuck and which ones didn't. And just for fun, we're going to do all the lines of the court in black except for the kitchen line, which is here and here, and we're going to do that in yellow. I've got a little spreadsheet that shows the different tapes we used. We needed 52 yards of black tape and 13 yards of yellow tape to do it the way we wanted. First, the black. We tried Ace Professional, 3M Extreme Hold, and Gorilla Tape, and some regular old junker duct tape that I had in the cupboard forever, along with that PVC marking tape that I have originally. In the first column, you can see the length of the roll, how many rolls you need for one court, the cost per roll, cost per yard, rolls needed for one court, and total cost to buy for one court. They aren't too bad except for the PVC marking tape, which is $25. The other ones are between $9 and $19. For the yellow tape, we only needed 13 yards, so we needed one roll of each. You can see the rolls of the duct tape is 15. 3M exterior surface is 41. The thing about the 3M rough surface is actually painter's tape. It's paper. I didn't like it very well. You only need one roll of each and it's between $4 and $12. So this means that you can do the taping marking of a standard pickleball court between $14 and $38 using the tapes. Now we'll show you how we did it. And we have lined it by putting dots on the cement court. Here, that's a tennis court mark. This is a pickleball court mark. Here's the dot for the kitchen. Okay, this is surface preparation phase one. What we did is we used our professional power washer. It's 3,300 PSI, 2.5 gallons per minute. And we washed all the lines. You can see how the lines, we power washed all the lines to get all the stuff out. Kind of makes it look a little funny because they're this court's 17 years old and it's made the washed areas look a little lighter. What we're going to do today is pressure wash all the lines where we're going to be putting the tape. We've already done that before on this section. You can see the pressure wash right here and right there. We're gonna just go over that lightly. Then we're gonna do the far tape over there. And I'm gonna pull up the APT stuff. And then we'll be ready to do a light air blow with a very powerful blower that I've got on Monday, and then we'll lay the other tapes down.
Well, do you want
me when you're on?
I'm on.
Okay, surface preparation part two. We're going to use this super pooper leaf blower. It's an Echo 8110. It's 80cc, 80cc, I have no idea what horsepower, but it puts out a hurricane. And we're gonna clean the line. We pressure washed it about 2 days ago, let it dry. Now we're gonna do a final line cleaning before we lay the tape.
Okay,
start, Jack. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the tape not on the yellow, but right up against it. And then Nathaniel's gonna pound it down a little bit, stand on it. And then what I'm gonna do is stretch it and then release tension.
What's that like?
And what we're gonna do is we're going to make sure that it's perfectly straight, perfectly straight. Before we set it down, then we're gonna release tension a little bit, put my end down, and then Nathaniel is gonna walk on it. Are you videoing?
Yes.
Okay. Cut. Okay, now what we wanna do is we wanna secure the tape down to the cement. And there's two ways to do that. The first way is just take a rubber mallet. Hold yours up, Sam. Oh, Betty's got it. We're gonna just pound it. What we're gonna do is we're gonna try something a little bit different. I happen to have this ancient metal wheeled wheelbarrow. It's heavy in and of itself, it's solid steel. I put 80 pounds of water softener salt in it. It's been a pounding. We're just gonna drive this down the tape a few times. I can see that it'd be great.
It's like the perfect width, too. Why not just get the four-wheel and run that?
And see, if that'll smash it down to the cement.
Yeah.
May kill it. Okay, this is the completed sports court. This one is going north and south. The main one on the tennis net's going east to west, and then the one on the other side is going north and south. We'll see how well these hold. We actually malleted this one in, and then we rolled these two in. And here's the roll. You see it dented it pretty good. And we'll see which works the best. And we'll see which tape works the best too. Here is that advanced polymer tape, APT, $12 for 36 yards that I got off the internet. And you can see it's really not sticking at all. It's twisted, it's turned, it's buckled. And this stuff just doesn't cut it. So I wouldn't get that again. In final analysis, all three of the black tapes tended to hold very well. The Ace Professional is beginning to peel up a tiny bit. Our first choice would be the Gorilla tape. It seems to be a little thicker and a little nicer. Of the three yellow tapes, the Painter's tape, which was the 3M Rough Surface Yellow, didn't hold at all. It's gone. Don't use it. The 3M Exterior Surface tape we used on center court was just fine. But we really kind of like the Duck brand duct tape. It's a little brighter, almost a fluorescent green, held just as well, and a little tiny bit less expensive. So if we had to make this entire court out of tape, starting from the beginning, we would use Gorilla tape for the black and Duck brand duct tape for the yellow. It would be beautiful. Any of these tape worked, but those two are our favorites.
Thanks for watching, and just remember, if we were faced with the option of doing pickleball court striping with tape versus painting, we would definitely choose the taping. It's just so much easier and not as messy. And remember, work hard, play hard. We'll see you on the next project.